Hi, how are ya? So today's my day off. I had a wonderful interview and I accepted it. The goal is to get away from having to speak a second language on the job. Is it a bad thing? No. Is it a good thing? Yeah. But it becomes a pain in the ass when you have to converse with customers and make sure that you're not being looked at saying, like, you know, are you telling them the right thing and all this stuff. In French, it's a little bit easier because most of our English language is from French and Latin. So it's not too bad to hear what's being said. But it's the fact of trying to get into the airport in order to add more glitter to the resume. So it's important. But there's a certain way you do things, though. And here in Michigan, like I said, we have very intelligent politicians, and they keep hiring more intelligent politicians, so it gets better and better. So we are here at Elizabeth Park. Okay, we're at the spot where my mom and my dad take me to recover from this whole ordeal that we keep going through. This is actually my Wheaties box entrance, because here is where I get to show you where all my tennis tournaments mostly took place. Besides Royal Oak, up near the Shriners area, we don't go there. It's just a little bit. It's a little bit bad as far as construction goes, so we just don't travel there. But here in the southern part of the tennis tournament area, it's a little bit easier to get through, which is Trenton High, and then we also have Allen Park High. And they have more tennis courts than what we had. So yes, that's where we went to. And the reason why I picked those two, because I could have just toughed it out through the construction area like every typical Michiganian does. But the reason is because we had teams that were really better than us, and it was probably I want to say out of my whole tennis career the biggest highlights for me. And in fact, the tournament in Trenton High is where I got into the newspaper as far as photo image wise. So in our local newspaper down here, as far as getting big into the sports areas, is the News Herald. That was our newspaper. We weren't expecting much. So at Trenton High, it was Groseal, Trenton High, and then we had Gabriel Richard, the Catholic school, not Ann Arbor. And then we also had, who else was it? I think there was one other Class A team. So we weren't, none of us were expecting to get through Groseal, but I did, and then I managed to get through another tennis tournament. I think Wyandotte. No, I don't think Wyandotte. Was it Wyandotte? Yeah, Wyandotte. I'm sorry. I had Wyandotte High. So I went through that, and then I got up to GR, and everybody knows the whole battle between me and GR, because it was an elementary classmate I was going up against. So we both had tempers. We both had emotional, angry personality is what they always said to us. And it was, and I termed it that way because she had one type of emotional, angry personality. I had the other side of it. So it was kind of interesting to watch, you know, both of us play. But did I have a cooler head? Always. Always. Because I was notorious for breaking my tennis frame. So, which I do. But now it's for a different reason. But anyways, yeah, this is the spot that my parents take me during actually 60 days. Okay. During the 60 days. And that's set up by my lawyer. Okay, believe it or not, that's set up by my lawyer. My lawyer has been doing that for the longest time. And I will not change my lawyer because we have been through a lot. And when I mean by a lot, I mean a lot. Man has tried everything possible to break this old collar. But we come to grips that maybe this is what is getting us through a little bit. So it's up for debate. But yes, it is. There is not much here. There is a river. There is an ugly old bridge. Sugar pixie sticks. You guys never did a project with those? Those sugar pixie sticks? Hold on, let me get them. You never had to do like an earth science project? What the hell is the matter with you people? I gotta put like those little smoke towers. What do I use? Orange pixie sticks. That's what we used. Red if you wanted to really get close with it. So yeah, there's not much. Yeah, did we go through this? We went through this, but I didn't pick it, did I? So yes, this is also where Pumpkin has walked, the church, okay? So around this area, if you walk, it's a big circle. There is a nice part, nice neighborhood on the other side of it that is actually a blue collar neighborhood. Across there, that's white collar. That's white collar, we don't go near there. But yeah. I wanted to show you where I hang out. And no, it's not a bad thing. It's a good thing. Technically, you can't go anywhere on a PB. You have to pay off all your debt, all your assets. And then you're also going through some other stuff. I know because I went through the other end of it. I had no choice because there was like nothing. It was either go through something horrendous, horrible, or just stay on the other side of it. So I stayed on the other side of it for a few lifetimes. Yep. So that's how I know. But yeah, this is a beautiful park here, and I'm sure my sister's gonna say something and fuck it all up. My sister's not with it sometimes, with all this, but. There's nothing to it. It's just a walk path and everything. We hang out, walk Pumpkin, we sit by the river. Wyandotte, that's Bishop Park. That's another area that I go to too. I try to stay out of Wyandotte only because that's the old stomping grounds. The old ceramic days stomping grounds. So I try not to go there as much, although I would like to, just to see what kind of I guess you can say like space, like past time would follow me, just to see. But I won't venture it. But yeah, that's pretty much it. Nothing to it. So let's go check out Riverview. Riverview is the other one. Riverview High. That's an important match. That day, my coach actually approached me and said, "You didn't drink water all day. You didn't rehydrate. You didn't do anything. You didn't even come up to the fence. I want to know, did you play this?" Knowing you had played it already, I looked at my coach. I says, "Coach, it's the end of the fucking season. I either know I got skills or I don't know I got skills. Okay?" And I walked away. I was so mad. I couldn't believe that man walked up to me and said that to me. Because what it was that the other player walked off not too happy. But like I said, it was one of the few matches towards the end of the season before hitting regional. So it was like a redundant, stupid question. Yeah, let's go check it out. Let's go check out my Luca Rossi statistic days. This ought to be fun. You ever play tennis? That's boring as hell. But it's stressful though. It is. When you gotta play by yourself and you're realizing your coach doesn't care for you anymore, it's stressful. Fun park. So this is Trenton High's tennis courts.
think they added a couple cords and removed a lot of trees because this used to be all shaded. I'm just only going to show like where there's no tennis players at. That far, so be right here. But because of the extended, we'll stay here. So between this, which is over here, that was my first match, Grozio. I won. I couldn't believe it. Then, all the way there, the first court over there, because that's where all the girls are at right now. It's girls' tennis practice right now. First court, my second match was against Wind Up. I remember. Because the girl kept, oh my God, she kept doing something. She was Hindu. And she had all these men attached to her hip. I could have slapped her. Because I seriously wanted to tell you, you should put it on your frame of the racket, Tootsie. At the rate she was doing. But, let me see. One, two, we're right here. That's the tennis court that I played on against GR. And got my picture taken. I was so happy. I was so happy too that day when the match was over because GR had won the whole entire tournament on all flights. And it was also their coach's birthday that day. I was happy because I was extremely exhausted. I was hydrating as much as I could, but when I came home, I dropped dead. I dropped dead. But yeah, so that's Trenton High School's tournament. Now we're going to go to Allen Park. Or Riverview, whichever one I can get to. Okay, we're here at Riverview. It hasn't changed, just resurfacing, as always. So it's always been covered like this. Huh? Always been. And the court that I played on was 1, 2, 4. It was the fourth court right here. I don't know if you guys can see it, but they have practice going on. So it's the fourth court. This was interesting because I brought my cooler full of water. Again, the match must have lasted no more than like 45 minutes. And I remember, like, coming off the court. Because right before my coach came up to me is when I had the foreseeing of Miscavige's letter coming. Because there was something, like, my friend had said next door. She said, like, when you get the Wizard of Oz poster, you're able to see what's to come next. Okay? Because that's how all American good family. An all-American family gets. So I've said this, right? But before it wasn't like, hey, let's pick Tom Cruise to help out and stuff, right? Because it's pretty much, let's see if everybody can remember how we are, because I've got like a shitload of problems. But yeah, this day when I played this match, I slept before my match. I always sleep before my matches. And I was nervous. I was nervous because I just finally started to master the strength of my forehand, and not relying on my backhand. But I was actually starting to rely more on my serves. What was nice about this is that I was my last match with the same player that I had kept winning against. So that's why I was nervous, because had I lost against it, it would have meant a bad thing. Because when you're winning, when you're having a winning streak and then all of a sudden towards the end of the season you lose, that means something. And I didn't want to be accused of it, because that wasn't the case. It wasn't the case at all. But yeah, I got off the court. I wanted to go to sleep. I had such a massive headache, but I didn't have one during the whole time. Really screwed her out of a lot of things. I said, how did I screw her out of a lot of things? There was no unforced errors, no errors forced against her. There was like nothing.
the game played as it did. And couldn't understand what he was getting at. Like, I didn't give her a challenge. No, that was not what I wanted to do, because had I done that to her, I think it would have been, like, a regional match. And she wasn't even in my division. We played against these teams to gain extra practice time against the heavy hitters, because we were such at a low class level. We had completely lost from being class, I think we were class C, maybe A. I mean, we were making it into states and then finishing off states. I entered into the varsity team. It was like, okay, all shit's gonna be just crawl over each other's. But this was always our last, most of the time it was always our last. Most of my matches, I either felt the win or I didn't felt the win. And there were just some days where I went to my matches and I didn't want to care to look into it. So I just, like, put in my earphones and blasted as loud as I could through my, like, iPod, which really had mostly Shine Down on it. That's why it was, like, yelling at Donald Trump, get the fuck off my fucking training Dianetics, because that's all I listened to. The first one, oh, and Hinder. Hinder was the other group. So I had, like, Lips of an Angel, I had Shine Down song. It's like, get off of it, man. Because sometimes I have to go that far back. Otherwise, I have to go to Vancouver, put in Hinder, Shine Down, Tayo Cruz, Pussycat Dolls. No AC/DC or Metallica. Like, are you planning to get off the court and sing, like, a blues melody or something with your cowboy hat on, like, dragging your racket like it's a guitar? It's like, I'm listening to country music. I'm trying to be whole. Okay. But there's a hole in your racket, though. I'm sorry. But, yeah. My cooler was a bright lime green on the pastel light side, and I had water in it. I didn't touch it. I walked through it, served, stroked through, and then got off the court, and I was approached about that. So it was all perfect. It was like no headache, walking off the court, no headache, and all of a sudden, poof, there goes the coach hitting me with, like, I couldn't believe it. So, but yeah, always look forward to this match. Always look forward to playing Riverview. Didn't care for, like, Our Lady of Shrine. Bishop Foley, though, was a scary team to play against, especially junior and senior year, because they kept getting taller and taller and taller. So my competitor was, like, 5'10" on the softball belt side, and I was like, what the fuck? All the coach's son could say, just focus on your serve, okay? Just focus on your serve. Don't let the size get to you. And he was right. I mean, because I was looking, I'm like 5'2" midget with a little racket that's probably like up to my waist, like half my size. Just like, I'm gonna just push it over here. She's just slamming right in. Like, that's like competing with the doll's, like, youngest sister. It really is. Like, holy shit. But yeah. But we're gonna go actually to Allen Park High. The start of every fucking season of the 4 years I was in tennis. And you wouldn't believe which freaking classic was the one we had to go to. Jaguar. Here it's Pirates. Over at Allen Park, they're Jaguars unless they change the mascot. It was our first tennis tournament of every season. Allen Park High. It was. Our first team actually would have been our first team that we would have played. Well, here comes the sneeze. I want to say Our Lady of Shrine. Could be wrong though. Could be wrong. But yeah. We're actually here at Allen Park High because our tennis courts at the time were not, weren't home court playable, I guess you can say. So Allen Park was our area to come and play our home matches. And I could tell you on which court I played. But yes, Jaguar Classic was our first tournament every year. And it was always here at Allen Park we came to, and then we split up. It was either Lincoln Park High, which was sophomore year for me, and then the rest of it was here. And then I think one year we got rained out. So, yes, which year was that? Junior year. I remember that year. So, senior year, I don't think we played the Allen Park tournament. I think it was just because there wasn't enough teams to play, but still you have to consider it because every year for the first 3 years we played it. And then like the last year, just, we didn't have enough teams to want to come play. So we did try. Anyway, so here we had Our Lady of Lakes, Gabriel Richard, Ann Arbor GR. We always took turns, either like the other years or like if the team wanted to play us again, we always took turns as far as like traveling and distance and stuff, because one of the things we always enjoyed about traveling long ways was to take the naps, pretty much. I mean, we did do homework, but it wasn't, like, anything we wanted to do. But, yes, these are the tournament courts right here. They have practice going on. But Our Lady of Lakes, second court, not here, but in the back courts. That was a big deal for me. Junior year. Was it junior year? No, still sophomore year. Sophomore year. Our Lady of Lakes, we played them over at their place junior year. Sophomore year, we had them come and play with us here at home. Big deal because at the time, it was acing. And I was doing nothing but that. And then I got bitched out by my coach. So it was like the whole freshman year, it was like, you need to ace. And then like start of like sophomore training, You need to ace. And then, like, here I am, one entire match acing, and it's like, you're just being a flat-out bitch. He probably would have said cunt. I mean, because he was that type of coach to get lippy with us. But I didn't get upset. I was, like, completely... How should I say it? Just asymmetric personality. Like, I was just, like, to myself. I had asymmetric hair, all that stuff. Just a complete jerk. And he was like that throughout the whole year. Luckily, we had Coach Joe, which was like, Joe and him, they were Luca Brasi brothers. So there was like no break with the whole freaking high school telling tales of stories and bras being thrown around. And Joe was like a football star. So he had the bad knees and everything, but he actually wore his Luca Brasi blue eyes. That was sad to see. So, those of us that loved Joe, we always stayed with him, and I was one of them. So that's one match I remember the most. Another match over here, far court down. GR. No, I'm sorry, GR. No, we played at their courts. their courts is actually in Southgate. It's behind next to their municipal city hall building. In the post office, that's their courts. We always played them there. They didn't want to ever play on our courts. I don't know why. But that was GR. What other teams do we play? We play Green Hill. Green Hill, we always played there. Oh my God. Talk about being like destroyed before you even walked on. Like, hi, how are you? Like, so nice to see you guys. So nice to see you trying. Why don't you come and play with us? Because, like, we just need pals to play with right now. You walk on there and you, like, senior year, it was like, oh, okay, yeah. One singles actually takes hold of flight. But I do the same thing, too, if I've, like, got a winning streak going on. I need to lose one here or there, you know, just to make the resume look good, the college resume application look good. Because that's exactly what it was. Like, you know what it's like to hit a backboard player? That's all it was. And my coach was, like, not into, like, what he had preached the freshman year, like, my freshman year, which would have been, I don't know which year it would have been, but he had been coaching a long time. Like, he coached his kids, and then he started coaching his friends and all that stuff. So it was like, it wasn't like this man didn't, like, bring home wins and stuff. So he did. But it was just funny because come my senior year, I'm being told not to be that type of player. It was just ingrained all 4 years. Don't be that player. And then here he's, like, applauding and praising this one person to be, you know, exactly what he's telling us not to be. And it's just like, you gotta be shitting me. All those fucking crazy people. Because it is. Green Hill was actually, no, Green Hill was, like, out of our class. So for them to take us on as a, like, team to play against, no. No. There are high school teams that can play, you know, can do, like, a practice play. Like, a literal practice. Okay, everybody, we're going to have this team come by, but I'm going to train you how to play your matches because we've had scouts look at them and tell you exactly what they're going to do. So we just want you to just make sure you do all sorts of things. Because even I was like, wait a minute, I feel weird. Like, you know, so then I started to change it up. Always change it up. My second racket was the changer. It was. I never let anybody know that I had played with the second racket. And that day I had switched to the first racket. And I sat there. I says, we got 20 minutes. I can change your grip. And I changed the grip of my second racket. But I had done something to mark it. Because it was like, that was my racket I played with when I had to go into, like, Catholic League and stuff like that. And regionals. So, I don't remember too much about regionals. All I know is that we had the first two teams, and then, like, pretty much we lost. We lost at most, like, third round. Some of us actually lost, like, the first round, which wasn't a big deal. I don't think any of us wanted to continue going to play into states because we were exhausted. We didn't have easy school days. Junior year, I think, was the only year I could say that I had the easiest school days as far as, like, homework, dealing with teachers, having to, you know, learn, absorb, relax, have fun, stuff like that. But senior year was brutal. Freshman year, sophomore year, all that stuff.
What the hell was that team then that I played? Let's go through the list. Shrine, Riverview, Green Hill, Our Lady of Lakes, Ann Arbor, Richard. Maybe that's what it was, Ann Arbor, Richard. Yep. It had to been.
Because usually those, that team, or was it Bishop Foley? Could have been also Bishop Foley, too. Those were the two teams I played the longest as far as, like, court time. Bishop Foley lasted almost, like, a full 2 hours. I mean, I was tired. That Catholic League tournament really, like, just killed me. I was just like, we're in the last round, and here I am. This is like the 5'10" girl. I'm just like, you gotta be shitting me. How many times could you change your fucking shoes? And she's like, my feet hurt, my this hurt, and da 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 da. I was like, you're joking. Just serve. And then it was like, she's left-handed. Is that allowed? I'm like, are you serious? Are you fucking serious? She was trying everything to just get the match thrown. Because she couldn't start off with the right pair of shoes. I was just like, you have got to be fucking kidding me. So, and that's exactly what the coach's son was saying to me. Just ignore her. Yes, you are left-handed. Yes, you are allowed to play tennis. I was like, oh, good. But it was to shake me up. But it was just like, you could have picked something else. Like, hey, by the way, that's a forced error. And I would have been like, okay, what do you want to do? Because you can technically replay a point if it's a forced error. Because these girls, they got trained at a young age with this, like, racket bigger than them and stuff. So they would come up with all these rules. And it's just like, okay, not a big deal. Do you want to replay the point? No, how do you replay a point? Really easy. Do you want to replay the point? Because you said it was a forced error. I forced it on you. You have to replay it then to tell me how I forced it. Because it was just like, what do you mean for? Like, because here now it's like, so you guys marking down like errors and stuff? Because even like because the son's coach was like, you got to be shitting me. Because I was just like, go through this all day long. Because you have to figure out what the fuck you're forcing. Like, am I forcing like you to put the ball in the net? Am I charging too quickly? Like, holy crap. It's like the dumbest shit with this damn tournament. No, we are not driving all the way up. It isn't, is it Royal Oak? I think it's in Novi. I think it's in Novi because it wouldn't be in Royal Oak. If it is in Royal Oak, then that's my bad. But we are not driving all the way up there. But yeah. This is where our home matches were at. And yes, I did play long matches. My first year I played doubles. Now I know why we won't drive up there. Royal Oak tournament didn't stay in one place until they actually found a site. We call them tournament sites. First 2 years having to play in the Royal Oak tournament, we were spread out throughout Royal Oak and Southfield. So I forgot where we're at in Royal Oak. We were at another high school in Royal Oak. We might have been at Royal Oak High. So that was where the doubles played. I was four doubles. I was happy there. Yes, I was. And then I got moved up to one doubles, and then I fucking hated it. And then they moved me down to two doubles, and that's when I had a partner, and I was like, okay, I gotta bare my teeth with this one. Then we ended up playing a tournament all the way up in Muskegon. That was against Benton Harbor, Muskegon. What else was there? I don't think Almont. Almont was the other tournament. Hold on. So Almont was the other tournament. We don't speak of Almont because I only think we only did it like 1 year, 1 or 2 years, and then that was it. Because it was just a pain in the ass to drive up there and then drive back. It was a waste of time. Same thing with Muskegon tournament. It was a pain in the ass to do all the reservations and stuff, so we stopped, I think, at sophomore year. Junior year, senior year, we focused being a team, and I kind of went, yeah, no, yes and no. So pretty much the party days were like the first 2 years, but they really weren't party days. They were switching days because the team was starting to come out of being athletic into being just a place to say you did something. You were in a sport. So it kind of sucked. So that drive to win and that drive to succeed wasn't there. Because here's what it was. It's like, well, if we do this as a team, we'll win it as a team. No, that's not how they did it. That dynasty of players did not do it that way, trust me. It just wasn't there. We had one girl come in with skills, but then it was just like completely selfish. Just wanted to be mean and brutal instead of being like groomed and stuff, because I came in like that. And so I ended up being like molded and clayed out into this like tennis player. Is it a bad thing? No, I just don't care for it. I mean, should I go in a league? Maybe. I don't know. I prefer bowling league versus a tennis league. I really do, because I don't want to get caught up in that like soap opera. It's like soap opera. It's like, well, so-and-so's dating this person and, you know, watch how he serves and stuff and how she flirts with him. Then next week he'll change and go with this person. Watch how she'll act and all this stuff. And she'll take it out on us because we're not helping out that type of pooling. I'm sorry. I just came here to play. I'm sorry. So really, this is like a dating club then, because apparently so-and-so's dating and that's why the serve went out of the box and I have to give her the point. Oh my God. Having really a rough day. Like, oh, holy crap, just play. So I'm not so sure. I mean, that's $5,000. It is. It's $5,000 to tour with the league plus spending money. But in a bowling league, though, with training a little bit and then being on a local league, then going into tournaments, it's a little less costly. It's like $3,500. It is. With the money that I got, yeah. That's it. So, yeah. It's funny, this is Champaign Park. I keep forgetting that it's on Champaign Road. I always do. I drive all the way out the right way. Because you have to take it a certain way. You drive all the way out to Allen Road. And then I forgot which fucking road to turn on Allen. So. But that happens. That happens a lot when you're trying to do it without GPS. So, Elizabeth Bishop and then Champaign Park. But yeah. Is that a lot happened here? We really didn't have a lot of home tournament or home matches. I'm sorry, we didn't have a lot of home tournaments and home matches. We were a poor school. If I showed you what type of concrete courts we had, you'd be like, you guys weren't even on a court. You guys just like grabbed some paint and painted a parking lot. Pretty much what it was. I mean, you want to talk about having bad knees after, like, 8 hours on them and stuff. Because there was none. Because as soon as you tapped, as soon as you stepped on the court for the first, like, 15 minutes, your feet were gone. They were. Because there was, like, no cushion whatsoever in your fucking tennis shoes. None whatsoever. It's raining. That's why I'm looking out. I'm like, I'm really like a DQ blizzard right now. But I'll hit DQ. I'm not DQ. Baskin-Robbins for the nutty coconut. Because that's really good. Plus, I gotta make hamburgers. Yep. And go pick up goobers and stuff. So, yeah. Welcome to Down River. Yep. So, that's it. Oh, what did my sister do? Because she was in, like, grade school and stuff. Bitch. Completely bitched. She bitched that this was a waste of time. We could have dropped her ass off of that fucking local library called Allen Park Public Library and just hung out there. But I guess I needed to hear the bitching. She did curse me one fucking match, though. She did curse me a match because I did yell at her. I says, that match, I should have won it. I think it was against Riverview. Let me see. Yeah, it was against Riverview. It was. Because she said she was hungry. I'm hungry. I wish this fucking day would just go by. Oh my God, she was just bitching up a storm. Bitching up a storm. And then afterwards, that's when my mom started bringing a second lunch for her. Because it was just like, you're not doing... Because I was super pissed. I was like... I did. I sat there. I had all my tennis stuff with me, my records, my stats with me in my bag. I went through it. I says, you know what? I have never lost against this fucking player and this team. I says, thank you very much for doing that. I says, so if you want to talk about being like nose in the air about stuff, that was it. That was the day. It was the only day I got nose in the air about it because I was super pissed the fuck off she did that. We played another school. We played Jewish Academy, but we didn't start playing Jewish Academy until like junior year. And that's like, it's like equivalent between Our Lady of Lakes and then Ann Arbor GR. So it was like hit or miss. But I always won against them. It wasn't a big deal. It's just not like losing. It's not like, it was like, you don't lose your edge and you don't get cocky about it. So it was that kind of a type match. But every match was different with every player. But GR, never won. I'm glad I didn't because I don't want to know what the hell would have happened afterwards. So, that's it. The highlights. Big time highlights. Nothing bad. Alright, that's it. I gotta go.